Now I am going to discuss the concept of to find the n value of n when the nth term of an AP is given and the AP is also defined. For example, we are given that we have an AP with terms A1, A2, A3 and so on, and we are AN, and we know that the value of AN is equal to A1, A plus n minus 1 into d, or we can say the value of nth term is a plus n minus 1 into d. So whenever we will use this formula to find the value of n when we are given a and we will find d from the ap, and an is given, and we will use the formula, the concept of linear equation, to solve that equation. So for example, we are given an ap. Find the n, the number of term minus 81 will represent when the AP is 21, 18, 15 and so on. That means we are supposed to find the value of n for, or we can say we are supposed to find the value of n for which the term will be minus 81. As the AP is 21, 18, 15, so A will be equal to 21. Now we will find D1, it is equal to A2 minus A1, 18 minus 21, we get minus 3, and D2 is equal to A3 minus A2. That means 15 minus 18 is also minus 3, as D1 is equal to D2, so the difference is equal to minus 3. And we are supposed to find the value of n when a of n is equal to minus 81. Now we will substitute the values in the formula. An is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. So minus 81 is equal to 21 plus n minus 1 into minus 3. So it will be minus 81, 21 plus, or we can say minus 3n plus 3, or minus 81 is equal to 24 minus 3n, or we can say 24 minus 3n is equal to minus 81. So we can further solve the for n. It will be equal to minus 3n is equal to minus 81 minus 24, and it will come out to be minus 5n 105. Minus 3n minus will cancel out, n will be 105 upon 3, so it will be 35. So the value of n will be 35. That means the 35th term of this AP will be equal to minus 81. So this is how we can find the value of n when the nth term is given and the AP is also given. As we were given the AP 21, 18, 15, we first analyzed whether this is an AP or not. For this, the A was 21 and D1 came out to be A2 minus A1, which was minus 3. Similarly, D2 was A3 minus A2, which was again minus 3. We saw that D1 is equal to D2. So we have analyzed that the terms are in AP and the common difference is minus 3, and we were supposed to find the value of n when a of n is equal to minus 81. Now we substituted the value of an, a, d in the formula, and we solved for n, and we found that n was equal to 35. So this is how we can find the value of n when the nth term is given and the AP is given. Question can be further extended. That means we have to see whether 0 lies in the AP or not. That means we have to analyze whether 0 is a term of this AP or not. For this we will use the same method. That means now the AN will be equal to 0, and we have seen that A is equal to 21 and D was minus 3. So we will find the value of AN. We will find the value of AN when A, using the formula A plus N minus 1D. That means 0 is equal to 21 21 plus n minus 1 into minus 3, or we can say 0 is equal to 21 minus 3n plus 3, or 0 is equal to 24 minus 3n, or we can say minus 3n plus 24 is equal to 0, or minus 3n is equal to minus 24. This minus will cancel out and will be 24 upon 3, which is equal to 8. As it is a whole number, so we can say that 0 is a term of this series. And if suppose when we found the value, if we have got a fraction in it, then we will say that 0 is not the term of this series. But in this case, as we have found the value of n to be an integer, so we can say that it is an AP, and 0 is, we can say that 0 is a term of this AP.